Welcome back. It's time for this evening's newspaper headlines. Nitrates in rivers hit record levels. U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service reports loss of wetlands. Heavy June rain means manure happens. Yeah, I was going to make this a joke, but I don't think this needs a joke. You know what I'm saying, Todd?
Yeah, Jackie. I think what you're saying is you want to slow jam the nitrogen cycle.
That's right. I want to slow jam the nitrogen cycle, and I'm not the only one.
Hello, I'm Dr. Matt Helmers, and I too want to slow jam the nitrogen cycle.
Hit me three times.
Nitrogen is essential for life. It's one of the building blocks of proteins, DNA, and RNA, so you can't live without it.
Just like your iPhone.
Nitrogen makes up 78% of the atmosphere, but it is largely unusable in this form. Plants called legumes carry out biological nitrogen fixation, converting atmospheric nitrogen to a plant-usable form called ammonium, but they can only do this in symbiosis with soil bacteria.
Oh, yes. Symbiosis. Is there a Facebook status for that?
Bacteria are my friends. Hey, yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Together we're better. Todd, play that guitar.
There are many biological processes going on in the soil, transforming nitrogen to forms that feed plants, like ammonium and nitrate. Then you add some manure or anhydrous ammonia fertilizer on top for maximum plant growth, bulking up on nutrients.
The plants don't use all the fertilizer. The nutrients that remain are vulnerable.
Vulnerable? You leave me so vulnerable.
Vulnerable to loss with water.
Vulnerable.
Vulnerable to subsurface leaching into groundwater.
Vulnerable.
Cities and towns are left vulnerable.
Vulnerable.
As their drinking water supplies are threatened.
That's right, a wise guru of water quality. Increased nitrate levels in the water are also an increased food source for algae.
It's an all-you-can-eat like a pizza ranch buffet.
The algae populations then explode. Eutrophication is happening in waters from here to the Gulf of Mexico. When algae die and decompose, they use up the dissolved oxygen, creating a hypoxic environment.
Low dissolved oxygen, they call it hypoxic, to the fish and other creatures that seem to be toxic.
Excess nitrogen is vulnerable to being emitted as nitrous oxide, a greenhouse gas 300 times more powerful than CO2.
Where the differences are hard to see at close range, but humans are impacting climate change.
There's one other important fate we need to address, and that's denitrification. Good
Big
bacteria
word.
Convert nitrates to inert nitrogen gas, which is emitted to the atmosphere, bringing the nitrogen cycle full circle. But they need just the right conditions.
They need saturated conditions.
The wetter, the better.
An environment that's anaerobic, plus a large source of nitrate. Places like saturated buffers and wetlands are ideal.
Practices like cover crops can help with nitrogen cycling in the soil, keeping nutrients in place where they need it the most.
Cover crops, cover crops. Cover crops grow in the cover crops.
Nitrogen, 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 nitrogen. Balancing the cycle is our great quest. When we tweak it alone in places, vex the rest. To build up healthy soils, nutrients must be recycled.
And that's how we slow jam the nitrogen cycle.
Oh, yeah.